There's a lot of controversy around Common Core, or in Alabama's case, the College and Career Ready Standards. But the truth is, there's no such thing as a Common Core math lesson. These are standards. They are goals for students. And there are a myriad of ways to help students reach those goals. We'll look at two examples of problem-solving methods to try to clear up some of that confusion. Fractions are a huge source of misery for many people. Let's look at 1/2 plus 2/5. You may remember that that's 9/10, or you may not. What you also may remember is using a common denominator. Now that sounds like something really special, but what we're talking about is having common units. You cannot combine 1/2 and 2/5 because they don't have a common unit. So you find a common denominator. If you multiply the 2 by 5 and the 5 by 2, you get a denominator of 10. But you've changed your fraction unless you also multiply the numerators by the same quantity. If you do so, you get 5/10 plus 4/10 is the 9/10 that you remembered. But there's another way to think about that. You could also use an area model. So if I model 1/2, I can draw a square and partition it into two pieces and shade one piece. Then if I wanted to model 2/5, I'd draw that same square and partition it into five pieces and color two of those. So I now have these two quantities that I want to combine. I need to do something with my halves and my fifths that would make them a common unit. So what if I also cut my half into fifths, and then I cut my fifths into halves? Suddenly I do have a common unit again of 10. So then if I count my pieces, I have 5 of 10 that represent that half, and I have 4 of 10 that represent 2/5. And if I combine those quantities, I get 9/10. And that is the area model method. It's not the only way to add fractions, but it is a really good way for students to visualize. Another source of confusion for parents these days is multiplication. We aren't just teaching the traditional algorithm anymore, and there are a lot of reasons for that. Students need to understand that you can decompose and recompose numbers into easier quantities to hold in your head. So, for example, if I wanted to multiply 38 times 26, I could break my 38 into a 30 and an 8, and the 26 into 20 and 6. Then I can multiply those partial products. I know that 2 times 3 is 6, and I can write those two zeros that I get from multiplying by 10 twice. 20 times 8 is 160, 6 times 30 is 180, 6 times 8 is 48. Combine all those partial products and I get 988. And that's the area model method. I prefer the distributive property. So I would take 38 and multiply it by 20, and then multiply 38 by 6. I get the partial product 760 and 228. Many parents are concerned about visualizing and taking these extra steps, but what we're really allowing students to do is make sense of the math for themselves. For those students who don't naturally think in these mathematical ways, hearing and seeing the mathematics enables them to be far more successful with higher level mathematics in high school and in college.